The search for missing Connecticut mother Jennifer Dulos expands to a reservoir near the home of her ex-husband, Fotis Dulos. Authorities searching for a missing Connecticut mother have expanded their efforts to a reservoir nearby the home of her estranged husband, Fotis, who has been arrested in her disappearance. New Canaan Police Lieutenant Jason Ferrero said the Connecticut State Police K-9 unit combed through the Metropolitan District Reservoir property in West Hartford on Wednesday for any sign of Jennifer, who was last seen alive dropping her kids off at a new Canaan school on May 24th. There's about a half a mile of woods between the water treatment facility and Fotis's home in Farmington, which has already faced several law enforcement searches, the Hartford Courant reported. Fotis and his 44-year-old gal pal Michelle Traconis are both facing charges of evidence tampering and hindering the prosecution's investigation into Jennifer's disappearance. Traconis and her daughter moved into Fotis's Jefferson Crossing home shortly after Jennifer left for New Canaan in 2017, around the same time she filed for divorce from her 51-year-old husband, according to the Stanford Advocate. Ahead of her disappearance, Jennifer and her estranged husband had been engaged in a bitter custody battle for the five children they share. The kids are currently living with their maternal grandma in her Manhattan home. Fotis, in his first sit-down interview after his arrest, lamented not being able to contact his children as authorities continue the search for the missing mother. "I'm very much worried about the kids and what they're going through. I want to tell them to hang in there. It's a big challenge in our lives, and things will work out and everything will be all right," he told NBC New York. "This is a very tough time. I'm sure they have a lot of questions. I'm sure they're missing their mom, and I'm sure they're missing their dad." Fotis, who has long denied playing a part in the disappearance of Jennifer, also continued to maintain his innocence during the interview on Tuesday. "I know what I've done and I know what I haven't done," he said. "I have to stand and fight and hope the truth is going to come out." Both Fotis and his gal pal are currently out on bail. Thanks for watching, guys. As always, leave me your thoughts and opinions below in the comment section, and I'm going to continue to pray for Jennifer and her family, and especially her children.